Welcome to the Trading with a Bot channel. I'd like to start a new series of videos dedicated to DCA bots. DCA stands for dollar cost averaging, and one of the bot platforms that excelled in the implementation of DCA bots is 3Commas. I'll introduce you to all of this slowly. In this first episode, I'll demonstrate capabilities of 3Commas and DCA bots by showing you Tiny Long Doge bot. The link to this bot that I am now highlighting is available below, in the description of the video. You can pause the video now, to click the link and see how my Tiny Doge had been performing since I posted the video on June 6th. You see that it had made 35 cents on June 4th, and 58 cents on June 5th. And today, so far, it has been a bit of a slow day. In sum, since the last 2.5 days, the bot had completed 38 transactions and generated a profit of 95 cents. This is the smallest bot that I was able to design, after countless experiments that I performed during the last 6 months. I'll post more videos about what I'd learned during this time, but let's come back to the Tiny Doge. The initial budget that I gave to this bot on June 4th was only $2.50. I am, of course, trading on the futures platform and using very high leverage. There are a number of settings that allow this Doge bot to survive and to generate profit. I will explain the settings and details. Moreover, you can copy this bot and reproduce these results. Use the same URL that I already mentioned. It is in the description of the video. If you do not have an account with 3Commas, you can open one for free. A free account gives you one free futures bot, and a free account is sufficient to follow the instructions in this video and keep the bot running indefinitely. So, once you open the link and click on the copy button, you'll see a screen such as I am showing now. From here you can click to edit the settings further, or you can press the start button and the bot will run. As I mentioned, you need to first register an account, and if you are just registering an account while watching this video, you will also need to add an API between 3Commas and your Binance Futures account. Once this is done, you can proceed to edit the settings. Trading on futures with a high leverage carries a very high risk. Recently the market had not been bullish or stable. Social media influencers cause unexpected price movements that can consume your maintenance balance and result in a liquidation. Please use the materials on my YouTube channel for learning purposes. I cannot be held accountable for any of the losses you may experience, although I will do my best to continue to educate you and to explain how to prevent such possible losses. For this bot that I am showing you now, I recommend you to fund your futures account with at least $25, even though I have just told to you that I had started it with $2.50. Even with $25 USDT as your starting balance, your daily net profit is around 2% per day. 2% per day is a very good outcome for a crypto bot that operates with such limited funds as only $25, and as I mentioned, this is the best smallest bot that I could design. As you copy this bot, you do not need to change any settings, besides, perhaps its name. I am now showing you the configuration of my Tiny Doge bot. When you first encounter 3Commas interface, you may find it incredibly complicated or confusing. Hopefully my videos will help you gain the confidence. For now, just watch me go through the settings, you do not need to modify anything. Select your futures account under the exchange section. Mine is called Main. And under the pairs leave the Doge/USDT pair. Next, as you see, I chose to have long trades on the Doge. And my base order is 5 USDT. The key feature of the dollar cost averaging, DCA bots, is the arrangement of the safety orders. Safety orders, SOs, create a grid-like order structure, after you place your initial, base, order. I keep the safety order size equal to 5. Note that every setting on this form will influence how the DCA bot behaves. Now, if you're familiar with trading on futures, you'll recognize that I use somewhat of the riskier setting of cross leverage and put the leverage to the maximum value. With the configuration of the DCA grids and the 50x leverage that I am presenting here, my bot will take up to 6 USDT and my liquidation risk will remain high, depending on the amount of my maintenance balance. If I wanted to remove the risk of liquidation and trade with no leverage, I would need to allocate 261 USDT for this bot. The profit is not influenced by the leverage, so unfortunately I would not earn more if I reduced or increased my leverage. I had gone over these concepts in depth in my previous videos. What changes only is the risk. If you have the sufficient funds to trade with lower leverage, I strongly recommend you to do so. If, however, you do not have the means to allocate the funds necessary to reduce the leverage, you can take the risk and trade with 50x leverage, and only $25. Next, I want to point out the settings on the deal start condition section. I plan to create more videos describing the numerous possibilities of 3-comma bots, and for now I will just say that there are other options besides of what you see here on the screen, allowing you to configure your bots. The setting I chose for the Tiny Doge bot is Open New Trade ASAP. This setting will ensure that the bot will work non-stop. The next section specifies the configuration for taking profit and stopping loss. I want this bot to behave a lot like a scalper, taking 0.35% of profit. If the price of the Doge will drop after the initial base order, the grid below with the safety orders will start getting triggered, one by one. Then, when the price recovers and goes back up, I want to calculate 0.35% from the total volume of all the positions and all the prices, not my initial first order. This is where the dollar cost averaging concept comes into play. So the setting on take profit type field is percentage from total volume. This is the most common setting for a typical DCA bot. And now, I reach the section with the configuration of the safety orders. I realize that it is difficult to understand the content, if you're seeing all of this for the first time. I promise to make more videos and visually explain how safety orders work. The settings that I use for the Tiny Doge bot are as follows. I use 6 safety orders, and they are triggered at 2.7% below my base order. Then, the size of my positions is increased by times 1.9, and these subsequent safety orders are spaced out with a multiplier of 0.7. Just keep all of these settings if you'd like to make an exact copy of my Doge bot. Then, I'll skip through the advanced settings section. There are no configurations that I entered there. We had now verified the configuration I am using for the Tiny Long Doge bot. We can now activate this bot by pressing the Create Bot button, and then pressing the Start button. As I mentioned, I recommend that you fund your Binance Futures account with at least 25 USDT, so that you minimize the risk of liquidation in case of the price going down rapidly. My current balance is much lower, as I am showing now. And if there would be a sudden dump or a market crash, I will be liquidated. But, if the price will continue to fluctuate up and down gradually, this bot will continue to make money. As mentioned, I am using the highest leverage available for Doge USDT pair. Currently the price of the Doge is fairly flat. Based on the configuration that I had just shown, the first safety order is located 2.7% below the base order, and my target profit is at 0.35%. I see that the last significant drop had happened yesterday at 9 o'clock, and as I am measuring it now, the price went down by 6.6%. This dollar cost averaging bot had handled it well. Even though it had probably opened its first buy position on the top, with the help of adding safety orders of a large size, the bot had sold the total value with a profit and recovered perfectly well, even though the Doge price was declining. Since then, I see that the bot had been idling, since the price was fluctuating between my take profit position and my first safety order grid. If the price goes up now, I sell with a profit. If the price declines, I buy a larger position that you see in my open orders, and then the bot will create a new order for the second safety order grid. I will now go back to my 3-comma interface and open the bot, so that you can see the details of the past transactions. By the way, here you can see that I have 3 different bots running. I have them running on 3 Binance accounts that I connected, Spot, Margin, and Futures. Let me now go back to the Tiny Doge bot that I had shown you. We're in the read mode now, but all of the configurations are the same as I've shown you earlier in the edit mode. What I want to show you now is the active deals section. For the type of bot that we've just configured, this section will show just one coin. We have an active deal on one coin Doge USDT. This section will also show how many safety orders were used up. As I had just shown in the Binance interface, we have yet to trigger the first safety order, and that is why we're seeing 0 out of 6 here. And finally, what you'll see on the right hand side are the past transactions. This one had taken 5 hours to take profit, but one below had made profit in 1 hour. What influences such bots' profitability is how volatile the coin is. Here's an earlier transaction, and it had only taken 17 minutes to take profit. And, when the Doge's price is pumping, the bot opens deals and sells each minute. I plan to come back to this particular bot in the future, and record the session when the bot is taking profit every minute. In my next video, I'd like to show you how I came up with these particular settings. It is no secret, I had identified the settings with a strategy created by one of the TradingView users. I'll open it now, but we'll explain it later. Just type 3 commas DCA and select script section when doing a search in the TradingView. What you'll see in a moment is a backtesting script created by person called Ruam. I will leave a direct link to this indicator below in the description. And the very next time I will show you how to use it. Well, there it is. On this, I'd like to finish the today's session. I'd like to thank you for sticking to the end. Do not worry if most of what I just described flew above your head. Trust me, I can relate to the feeling. Continue to try to follow the steps, watch the video again, and as always, drop me a comment here below or by joining our Discord community. The link to our Discord server is in the description. Till next time.